Welcome to my new video in Link Tutorials. Today I will explain another two operators under element operators category. The operators for today are single and single or default. You will learn today what does each operator mean and how can we use them in a link query. I will show you different examples using the both operators. At the end of this video you will be able to use the both operators once you need that. Let's go. In the first video about element operators I mentioned that each link query has an output. This output could be empty, or it could be a collection of elements. The collection could contain only one element, or also more than one element. Sometimes we don't need to get all elements, but only one specific element. To get a specific element, we can use element operators. We can also use element operators within the query, to filter the data we have and getting only one element. If you want to learn more about element operators, you can check the following video. I explained it in detail. What does it mean and when can we use element operators? Let's now start with these two operators. As the name suggests, both operators return a single specific element of a sequence. It means, I have a sequence containing only one element, and I want to get this element from it. Let's see the following query to understand how can we use these operators, and also to understand the difference between both operators. I have this simple query to get the numbers, which are greater than 5. The output of this query is the following collection. It contains only one number. If I want to get only this number, I can use both operators. Let's use both operators. I can use them in this way. I only write the operator with empty brackets. The result of both queries is the following number. It's the only number in the sequence, which I had as output from the query. Until this point, there is no difference between both operators. So we can use them in the same way and the result is also the same. This is the first way how to use these operators. Assume I have now another condition to get the numbers, which are greater than 11. The result of the query now is empty, because no number is greater than 11. Let's now use single operator on the left side. As mentioned, this operator is to get the element from a sequence. But the sequence now is empty. In this case an exception of type invalid operation exception will be thrown, because there are no elements in the sequence. Let's now use the second operator on the right side. As you know, the sequence is empty. The result of this query now is 0 and no exception will be thrown. But why I didn't get an exception and where is this 0 coming from? As you see, the query here is for an integer array, and the output also of type integer. The default value of integer is 0. So this operator returns the default value, if the sequence is empty. The sequence here is empty, therefore we got the default value of an integer. Therefore we got 0 as output. This is the difference between both operators. In summary, both operators are to get a single element from a sequence. But in case the sequence is empty, an exception will be thrown for single operator, and the default value will be returned for single or default operator. We can use both operators in another way. The first way was using the operator with empty brackets. The second way is using the operator with a lambda expression within the brackets. It means, we can set a condition in the brackets to filter the elements, before getting the element. If you don't know, what is lambda expression and how to write, please check the following video. I explained it in detail. Let's see the following query to check how to use these operators with a lambda expression. I have an array consisting of 7 numbers. And here is a condition to get only the numbers, which are greater than 5. The result of the query until this point is the following collection, which contains 4 numbers. Let's now use single operator with a lambda expression. I will write the following condition, to get only the numbers, which are greater than 8. The result of this expression now is the following collection, which contains only one number. And because I am using single operator, I will get this number from the collection. So the result of this query is the following number. I will get the same result, if I am using single or default operator. Let's now change the condition within the brackets to get the numbers, which are greater than 10. The result of the expression is empty, because no number is greater than 10. In this case an exception of type invalid operation exception will be thrown. But if I am using single or default operator, I will get 0 as result, which is the default value, because there are no elements in the sequence. Let's now change the condition again to get the numbers, which are greater than 7. The result of this expression now contains 2 numbers. In this case I will get an exception of type invalid operation exception, because the sequence contains more than one element. The same will happen if I am using single operator. It means, the sequence should contain only one element, so that I can use the operators without any exceptions. This is also how to use both operators with a lambda expression. Before I switch to UiPath, let me summarize both operators. Both are to return the single element from a sequence. Single operator. If the sequence contains only one element, I will get this element as output. But if the sequence is empty, an exception of type invalid operation exception will be thrown. If the sequence contains also more than one element, an exception will be thrown. It means, we should have only one element in the sequence, else we get an exception. Single or default operator. If the sequence contains only one element, I will get this element as output. If the sequence is empty, I will get the default value. The default value depends on the data type, which I have. For example, for integer type it's 0. For Boolean type it's false, and so on. If the sequence contains more than one element, an exception will be thrown. It means here, that we don't get the default value, but an exception. To use the operators we have two ways. Either without anything in the brackets. Or using a lambda expression. We can use both operators in any point in the query, but only as method. So we can use both operators only in method syntax, or in mixed syntax. That's all what you have to know about both operators. Let's now switch to UiPath to see some examples, where we can use both operators. The first example is about arrays. I have the following variables. The first one is an array variable. It's of type array string. I have the following names in this array. And the second variable is of type string, to store the result of the query. I want to write a query to loop these names and get the name, which starts with N. In this array I have only one name which starts with N letter. Let's write the query in an assign activity. I will write the query in method syntax. To learn more about method syntax, please check the following video on my channel. I explained it in detail. I have the array variable at the beginning, which I want to loop. After that I have where operator, to filter the array. The condition here is to get the names, which start with N letter. X variable represents the names of the array. At the end I added single operator, to get the single element from the array. I will add write line activity, to print out the result. Let's execute the code to check the result. As you see, I got this name, which starts with N. And this is the only name in the array, which starts with N. I will get the same result, if I am using single or default operator. I will change the condition to get the name, which starts with S letter. As you know, we don't have any name, which starts with S. Let's check what happens now. As you see, I got the following exception, that the sequence contains no elements. As mentioned before, if we don't have any elements in the sequence, we get an exception of type invalid operation exception. Let's continue. As you see, here is the exception type. And also the message, that no elements found. I will replace single operator with single or default operator. So I have the same condition, but with operator single or default. Let's check if we will get also an exception. As you see, I didn't get any exception. Only an empty string. As you know, we don't have any elements in the sequence. In this case we should get the default value. Here we have string data type. The default value for string is null. It means, if we don't have any elements, we get null as result. So it works fine. Let's check the last scenario, so that we have more than one element in the sequence. I will change the condition to get the names, which starts with E letter. So I have single or default operator. And the array contains two names, which start with letter E. It means, we have more than one element. Let's execute the code to check what happens. As you see, I got an exception, that the sequence contains more than one element. Here is the exception type. And also the message. The same happens if I am using single operator. These are the three scenarios, which we could have once we want to use single and single or default operators. In summary, we could have only one element, more than one element or no elements. That's all about how to use both operators in a link query. Let me now show you another example, how to use these operators for a data table. I have the following sequence. First, I have build data table activity, where I define a table. It's stored in this variable. Let's see the table. It consists of three columns, city, country, and capital. I have here different cities. And also two different countries. USA and Germany. In the last column I have either no or yes. For each country we only have one capital city. For Germany we have this capital city. And for USA we have this capital city. I want to get the capital city using single operator. Let's see the link query, how to do that. First I have a loop for the rows of the table. After that I am grouping the rows. The group is using the column country. It means, all cities of one country are now in one group. After that I am selecting the group variable. From each group I want to get single row. For that I have a condition to get only the row, where the capital column is equal to yes. It means, I want to get the capital city of each group. At the end I convert the output to data table. And here I have a loop for the rows, to print out the new value of the data table. Let's execute the query to check the result. As you see, I have only two rows as output, because I only have two countries. For each country I got only the row, which contains the capital city. This is how to use single operator within the query. We can do the same without using single operator. For example, this query returns the same output. But this was only an example to show you, how can we use single operator for a data table with group operator. That's all about both operators for today. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new and interesting. If you still have any questions, please don't hesitate to write us. Thanks for watching and have a great day.